We are on a quest to get the goodest of good boys, but unfortunately we must steal him from Hades in order to liberate him and bind him to our warpath, which is sponsored by Ares. Before we can do all that though, we need to invade Greece in order to earn the privilege of starting a holy crusade to get the flame pupper. Our journey starts with choosing Ajax because it cleans empires with the toughest of rulers, and he also happens to be a rock throwing prodigy. Nope. If you're looking for a tour guide who's essentially an ancient incarnation of Doomguy, Ajax has never met an enemy he can't defeat. Even his beard has killed 10 legendary warriors. But you can only choose Ajax if you intend on entering endless wars with your neighbors. And it looks like this neighbor thought we were a McDonald's drive-thru, so we marched out the Imperium of Man from thousands of years ago to liberate some soldiers. Their strength is so undeniable, in fact, that the idea of them picking up their club causes uncontrollable earthquakes that rattle your brain. Once I felt what it's like to chew 5 gum, I noticed there was land I did not own and it was only a short voyage away. So we set sail and deployed our moonwalking giants that can now throw spears, and then we took every unit we had and chased after the general, striking down our enemy through the power of too much masculinity. But what I love about Total War Troy is how one minute you can be looking at a beautiful sunny sky, and then you realize you have 2,000 troops running full charge at the neighborhood watch. Seeing as the military-industrial complex is the fuel for Ajax's economy and the key to getting the best good boy, I declared war on 3 new enemies and even called upon our useless allies to help. Fortunately, in this game, you don't need a Caesar salad to justify war. After taking a foothold territory, I went after their capital of Simp Metropolis, but in my haste, I didn't notice the whole extra army that was chillaxing at the Stegalopolis' facilities. These fools do not know the ways of the samurai as I do, so I whipped out the big brain and we split our army in two like any good horror movie would recommend, and we had the beefy boys barging in through one gate and a large number of grunts charging in from the other. Scared by our elite tactics, they folded like a cheap koala, and we took control of the victory point to get the easy victory royale. But surprise, surprise, every surprise is followed by more surprises. A full army against a bunch of nearly dead troops? I like my odds, because in this game, mental fortitude is more important than sharp sticks, and to ensure our people don't break, anyone that flees the battle gets stuck in a room to watch Sesame Street for the rest of their life. With this in mind, we polished off their morale by telling them that Santa isn't real, causing a mass wave of morale loss for the enemy. Finally, for once, a challenging brand to Ajax declared war on us, and one of our many enemies became a vassal, so we had to make a choice. Did I stutter? The issue with being at war with 10 empires is all of the unprotected territories that will now be repossessed by Mr. House. But on the bright side, it becomes very easy to maintain an empire when you can only have one territory at a time. It was hours of trading back and forth until we finally took a real city and denied every advance to make peace. Because even with one territory, they feared Ajax and his ragtag group of half-man horses, which somehow caused generals wounds by stabbing them 300 times. If we truly wanted to get our flaming Cheeto, we had to form a second army of McMuffins in order to expand twice as quickly as they can take our land. To win, we need numbers, because the Lord knows these troops lack any amount of intelligence. With this many people on the payroll, we simply didn't have enough Big Macs to keep them all sustained forever. But since every territory we take makes wood, we were able to indirectly feed our troops wood to keep them from revolting. I also got a chance to try out a new strategy right off the tactical hotline known as the EGILOISYBTWY, or the single file line formation for short. Looking at this again, I don't really like what it resembles, but that doesn't change the fact that it can saw an entire city in half. With that tactical dubski, we began moving north because I want to find the portal that leads us to the doggo. During this quest, the game glitched out and I began staring into the abyss for several minutes. Then the abyss stared back. After that, one of our armies fought another army, as on paper they seem to have the advantage, but our battleship ended up getting mercilessly sunk into the giant salt pool we call the ocean. The sight of having a nutritious and delicious economy was way too scary for me to handle, so I formed yet another army that had a great variety of spearmen, spearmen, and more spearmen. After 14 hours of gameplay, we were able to finally get Ajax to reach his final form, just in time to meet the Virginia Ham antagonist who isn't as powerful as even one toe on the mighty Ajax's hand. However, in order to fast track the plot of this video, we needed the help of the gods to defeat our sworn enemy. We were somehow friends already with the god of capitalism and the god of space travel, but only one god can help Ajax find our pupperino, and that's the god of war. Through the power of prayer, we brought peace to so many villages and their people. We were able to become the Sigma male and destroy the fragile minds of our enemy. Those who would stand in our way would literally get trampled, as I discovered if you simply ask your army to move through an issue, you will break the morale of whomever happens to exist in your way. Fueled by his love for the gods, Ajax became a competitive slapping tournament world champion and ascended to the status of one slap man. Through this power, civilizations fell and our enemies were chased out of their cities as we tried to search for where the spicy pupper was located. Then I finally discovered the button at the top of our screen, which allows us to begin the conquest for our doge. We had just taken so many people's land and committed most of the violations in the Geneva Convention, all because we didn't bother to click any of these buttons. The secondary perk to getting this beautiful boy is that you get to enlist the help of his loyal followers, the Blue Man Group. So I sent 600 groups and a commander on a journey of certain death, and after answering their questionnaire that was paced out over 15 turns, we reached the big battle at the gates of Hades to fight our good boy and his army of glow sticks. We very apprehensively charge the big man and use 4,000 troops to slowly whittle away his health as he yeeted groups of our units into the air. When his health bar dropped, we won the battle, and finally, Ajax and his dog were once again reunited in a semi-altered version of historical events. Now that we have the best boy, we unlocked a new form of currency called soul. And we need souls in order to enlist any kind of help from the pixie sticks. To get souls, we need more war, so we took the good boy out for a walk. As he marched towards terrified troops, he couldn't have looked any happier. So before the big battle, I stopped to make a couple of memories for the scrapbook. Then I let him go rip and tear the enemy to pieces. Ajax still can't focus his aim, and the only thing better than Cerberus eating people in a field is Cerberus eating people in the middle of a siege. I assigned everyone to climb the walls that could, but unfortunately, all the giants were too big to use ladders. It took 5 minutes for the battering ram to arrive, then a while to take down the gate, especially because they began getting attacked, and our second full army used ways and were walked around the entire castle to reach a destination they could have just walked straight to. Eventually, the gate did get barged down, but our good boy and his confident compatriots were a little too wide to fit through the small opening on the gate, so we brought another small infantry unit here to painstakingly turn this thing around and fix the jank parallel parking job they botched. Our flame boy was so happy, he crowd surfed his way on into the base and cracked open the attack with a fiery airstrike from the heavens, following it up by stepping on the general and launching many of our own troops into the air simultaneously. When he began running, I spawned the Blanos army in front of him, but it took them very long to spawn in and they were too slow to do any kind of good. So I had our big boy chase him down and do barrel rolls on his corpse. Then our good boy went for the final general at the top of the hill. After showing the general a few of his tricks like crushing his spine, biting his head, and staring, the general made the wise choice of running away after 20 seconds of conflict. And as a treat, we let Cerberus barbecue the souls of the city. Because you didn't get to see it in the last siege, here's the animation of our good boy opening up a portal to the Shadow Realm, doing a belly flop to clear out a group of people, and then stopping for a quick snack. If you want to see more heartwarming stories, check out our other videos where we nuke all of humankind. And as always, thanks for watching.